The Pirates rolled a victory, 73-69 in overtime. And for more, Mike Joseph with head coach Kia Damon-Olson.
Thanks, guys. The Leopards down 10 at one point, outscore Monmouth 28-14 in the final closing minutes in overtime. Overtime's getting to be a thing, Coach.
I wish it wasn't, but I'm happy we came out victorious.
Yeah, it's it took a little bit of time for you to find the right lineup, but once you did, things seemed to really click.
Yeah, their pressure really bothered us, and we spent a lot of time working on it. And we started sluggish, but once we kind of settled in with the pressure and got into running some offense, we got some good looks. And that's what I kind of kept telling the kids at halftime prior to the game, like, you're going to get great looks because it's a high-risk, high-reward defense, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Now, sometimes it's difficult for me to keep an eye on who's on the court because you went really deep today.
Yeah, and that's the benefit of having a deep team, knowing that if someone is not playing their best that day, we can make a sub and kind of elevate what we're doing. And we were fortunate enough that, you know, the kids came in today and were able to do that.
Coach, keep stacking them on top of each other. Great job today.
Thank you.
Let's bring the girls in here. Alex, why don't you come in here first? Alex Cantwell, one rebound away from a double-double. This is becoming a habit for you, and down the stretch, you guys really seem to play your best basketball.
Yeah, honestly, I wish we played a little bit better in the first so we didn't have these, like, heart attack moments in the end, but this is what we play for. It's so fun. It's awesome.
Yeah, what is the toughest part against a team that pressures you 94 feet for the entire game?
I think just staying composed, really, and playing our basketball. We're a really smart team, and we can really outwork people and outsmart them, so just knowing that we have to be composed, play our basketball, and then we're fine once we do that.
Sure looks that way. Have a great, good job.
You too. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Let's bring in Giselle. Giselle, freshman Giselle Havas. Giselle, 15 points today. You look like you found a rhythm both shooting and defensively today.
Yeah, I knew that once my team, we picked it up on the offensive and defensive end, because in the beginning when we got down, I knew I had to come off the bench and bring a spark to the floor.
Sometimes coming off the bench is a plus because you get to watch the action and see how others play, so that's got to be a plus for you.
Yeah, if my teammates need me, I know that I need to come in and help them out, and especially on the defensive end, that's where I like to come in and pick it up for our team.
Coach Laughlin told me today that we needed to find a third scorer, and today that was you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Guys, back to you. Great win for the Leopards.
Thank you very much, Mike, and obviously thank you very much to our coach, Kia Damon-Olson, for what is a great post-game interview, but have two players of the game on our post-game show presented by the Maroon Club, enhancing 23 Division I sports. Join the Maroon Club today. We had two players of the game presented by Coca-Cola, and of course you can experience the Coke side of life. Those two players off the bench, Alex Cantwell, a senior, Giselle Havas, a freshman. Different dynamic between the two, but key thing in this is we look at the highlights. There's a lot of back and forth in this one, and you needed every bit from every player in this game.
No question about it. And, Monmouth is a good team. You heard Kia Damon reference their three straight wins, and for good reason, because this team has a lot of answers. They're very talented and quick at the guard spots. They've got some great interior defense. But the thing I think I like most about this game today for the Leopards, Adam, is that everybody that was called upon did the job. You had great senior leadership from that young lady, Alex Cantwell, and then some unexpected contributions from the freshmen. This is a big bucket as Alex got pushed from behind and knocked that one down. And man, when she made that first one, you had the sense that Lafayette was in for a comeback. Sierra Green is everything we thought she would be. This was a play by Giselle Havas off the opening tip of the overtime period, and that seemed to just propel the Leopards to great stuff. Here's Giselle again with a downtown three, and boy, once Lafayette got the momentum back, there's the turnover. We saw a lot of this early on. Watch Natalie Kukowski just reject any chance that Monmouth had of coming back in this basketball game. And again, that leads me to my opening point. Even though Natalie struggled at times tonight, by her standards, she still had 9 rebounds. But she made that big block at the end that ensured victory. And how about the contributions from the freshmen? Michaela Wilson played 34 minutes. Naomi Gampo with 14 quality minutes. And, of course, Giselle Havas with 27 minutes. Those are big minutes for freshmen who heretofore really hadn't seen the court a whole lot. They came in big time tonight.
Yeah, and Havas, obviously one of the co-players of the game. Big reason why the Leopards outscored Monmouth on the bench 35-14. But as we look at the rest of the final stats presented by NAC Printing, we saw there the points in the paint for Monmouth. They had a stretch there in the third quarter where things looked really dicey because they had the off-ball movement and the ability to cut in. They really did a great job both offensively and defensively in the paint today. It's not just the pressure that they created, but the ability inside where you couldn't have a chance to breathe in the half court because of what they're able to do inside.
Yeah, it's kind of a poetic justice that this game did go overtime because both teams, I think they were evenly matched, and both teams were able to make adjustments throughout the game. Once Lafayette started solving Monmouth's full court pressure and got into their half court, again, you heard Kia Damon talk about it, they were able to get some better looks and get their footing offensively. Monmouth, on the other hand, they didn't do anything in the half court early on, and then they started finding their footing. This is a quality win for a young team that's really finding its stride.
Well, for the Leopards, it was a bit of deja vu here at Kirby. Last week against Albany, they had a 19-6 run over the final, 7:05 to force overtime. They won it in double overtime. Here today, a 16-3 run in the last, 5:30 to force overtime, and they get the win. Anything else to say is this team, they'll have a bit of a breather here. They'll have final exams. When they come back, they'll be at home for the unusual Thursday afternoon game, December 20th against Cornell, but they'll be home. So a chance here over the next week and a half or so, not just to get some mental breathing room to help focus on the classroom, but a chance maybe even to rest up a little bit and get some of those lingering injuries. Agnello's knee, Nicole Johnson, limited to 3 minutes, maybe not be 100% herself either. Chance for them to get some much-needed rest.
Yeah, you know what? It's a blessing in a way that the injuries and the illnesses to a couple of key people for the Leopards have opened the door for some younger people to get minutes when they might not have. So it could, in the long run, could turn out to be a very, very huge positive for this team down the road. Everybody likes the break, not necessarily for exam time, but it's a break nonetheless. And I think this team is just on the cusp of doing some very good things this year.
Well, with the win, the Leopards improved to 5-4 on the season. Monmouth falls to 3-5 again. The Leopards, they'll be heading to finals. We will have some action, though, after finals, and upcoming men's basketball action will be against Rosemont College, a Division III school from the Philadelphia area, but they'll be heading off finals December 19th, 7 p.m. tip-off right here on the Lafayette Sports Network. And for women's basketball action, again, the next game the following day, a 12 p.m. start time against Cornell. Obviously an exciting one here for my partner, John Leone, and for a great job on courtside by Mike Joseph. I am Adam Dobrowolski signing off. Thanking you so much for tuning in today's production right here on the Lafayette Sports Network, presented by the Patriot League Network on Stadium. The Leopards win in overtime, 73-69. Have yourselves a great rest of the weekend, everybody.